It's water all the way at this North Shore primary school, but it didn't take a hardline policy to change habits, just a weekly reminder in the newsletter since 2019.
We don't have students coming in with any sugary drinks at all, just from that simple message.
Now the government's proposing a ban on the sale of unhealthy drinks in all primary and secondary schools. It could mean all schools years 1 to 8 must supply only water, low-fat milk or unsweetened plant-based milks. One survey shows 68% of primary schools already only provide milk or water, but parents could still let children take unhealthy drinks to school, although a school could go further and implement its own ban.
Sugar-sweetened beverages account for more than a quarter of a child's sugar intake here in New Zealand. That's why we want to ask what people think about all primary schools offering only healthy drinks.
Do we want to see a system where there's rigid controls and rules from Wellington which will stop my kid having a Fanta at the school disco? I don't think so.
This principal also questions whether regulatory change is needed.
By making it just a habit rather than enforcing a policy, we've proved that it works.
The goal is to help reduce high rates of tooth decay.
I've taken out tens of thousands of teeth from young kids who are consuming sugary drinks.
But the Dental Association wants the proposal to go further.
Hats off to the Minister of Education for this first step. Ideally, what the New Zealand Dental Association is calling for is for a water-only policy in all schools.
The big drinks companies no longer directly supply schools, but distributors do.
We are just as concerned about this issue as everybody else, and our members have taken a significant amount of steps in the recent years to deal with that.
People can have their say on the proposal for the next 8 weeks. Kushla Norman, One News.